welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Lisa, also known as ladolcelisa, and in today's video, I'm going to be teaching you how to make the most delicious Italian dessert, perfect for Valentine's Day or any day of the year, really, and that is panna cotta. Now, panna cotta essentially means cooked cream in Italian. Panna is cream and cotta is cooked. So we are really going to be cooking some cream over a stovetop with gelatin. It's going to be a delicious creamy dessert that we are then going to top with a delicious berry compote on top. It's going to be so good. Perfect for Valentine's Day. This is the kind of little dessert that is so easy to make because you're essentially not baking anything. You're really cooking it on the stove and then popping it in the refrigerator until it is set and ready to eat. Now, I love panna cotta. I always get it when I see it at a restaurant, especially when I'm in Italy. It's delicious. And guys, this recipe is so good. Without further ado, let's get started and let's make this delicious vanilla bean panna cotta topped with a berry compote. Now, the first thing that we're going to need to do when we make the panna cotta is to prepare the gelatin. We prepare it and then that gets pushed over to the side until we need it again for the actual recipe. So let's first make the gelatin. I use just a packet of powdered gelatin. It works out being less than a tablespoon or so of gelatin, and I find this amount is perfect for a quarter cup of liquid. You can use any liquid here. I tend to just use some hot water. So to this quarter cup of hot water, I basically just microwave this for about 30 to 40 seconds. We are going to take this packet of gelatin and add this straight into the water and continuously mixing for about a minute or so. So after a minute or so of whisking, you'll notice that the gelatin powder has dissolved and it looks like sort of a thickened water. It's not quite gelatinous yet, but we're going to set that aside, and by the time we need it, it should be great. So we'll put this aside for now, and now we have to work on the cream part of our mix. Take a saucepan, and to the saucepan we are going to be adding our cream and our sugar for now, and then we are going to put this on the stove and bring it to almost a boil, but not quite. You do not want it to actually be bubbling, but you want it to get nice and hot, and you want the sugar to be nicely dissolved. So I'm going to be measuring out the cream. 1¾ cups of heavy 35% whipping cream, and 1 cup of 10% half and half cream. And to the cream, which is that heavy cream and also the half and half, we are going to be adding 1/3 cup of sugar. Now we are going to put this cream and sugar on the stovetop on a medium heat and keep stirring it until it almost comes to a boil. So now that the cream and sugar have come to an almost boil, we are going to stir in the gelatin mixture as well and mix that on the heat together with the cream and sugar for about 1 more minute until everything is nicely combined. Okay, so now that we have our cooked cream, we need to flavor this cream. You can flavor this with a vanilla bean, of course, but I just find that these days they're so expensive. A great alternative is vanilla bean paste, because that actually has the beauty of the vanilla bean little seeds in it, so you'll see that throughout. If not, you can use just vanilla extract, that's fine, or even perhaps your favorite liqueur, but I just find that vanilla bean panna cotta is delicious. So what we are going to be doing is adding 1 tablespoon of this vanilla bean paste, but if you don't have that, substitute the vanilla bean paste for 1 tablespoon of vanilla bean extract. I'm also going to be adding 1 teaspoon of vanilla bean extract just for extra vanilla flavor. Okay, so now that we have our cream, sugar, and vanilla mixture here, I'm going to transfer this into this dish because it is much easier to pour from this spout. So now that I have this cream ready to pour, I have a couple little dishes that I'm going to be placing these in. I like to use these really small cups because I find that they are so cute, or else you can even use cute little mason jars and they are really pretty as well. Or you can use a beautiful glass, a wine glass, or even a martini glass is really pretty. So let's first pour them into these little tiny containers. And I like to pour them to leave room for the berries that we're going to be putting on top. So don't fill them all the way, fill them about 3/4 of the way up. And also, since the vanilla bean tends to hang out at the bottom of the container, I like to re-pour in just a little bit more at the end so everything has the same amount of vanilla bean. So as you can see, I would say this recipe serves anywhere from 4 to 6 people, depending on the size of the little ramekins that you decide to use. I wanted to show you guys a bunch of different options. Of course, you can serve these with just fruit or caramel sauce or chocolate sauce, but I like a nice berry sauce or berry compote, if you will, so I'm going to be showing you how I make that as well. But in the meantime, before these go into the fridge, they have to cool, I would say, for about 20 minutes or so that they cool to room temperature and they're not piping hot. Then we're going to be covering these with plastic wrap and placing these in the fridge for at least 4 hours or overnight. we are going to be making the berry sauce or compote, but like I said, usually on panna cotta, there is either a mixed berry sauce, there is caramel, or there is chocolate. The choice is really yours. I just really love the tartness and freshness of the berries with that delicious sweetened cooked cream. It's so good. So what I have here are my favorite berries, so feel free to use your favorites. I really love strawberries and raspberries. So I would say I have 1 to 2 cups of raspberries, 1 to 2 cups of strawberries, making about 3 to 4 cups of berries in here. These are fresh berries, but feel free to use frozen as well if you prefer. And to that, I also added 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. That is just going to help with the thickening process. So right now I'm going to be adding the berries to this saucepan. And to that, I'm going to be adding 1/4 cup of sugar. Add 1/4 cup of sugar if you have 3 cups of berries, and add 1/3 cup of sugar if you have 4 cups of berries, or add as much sugar as you prefer. And now I'm going to be cooking this on a medium heat for about 5 to 10 minutes or so until the berries start to burst and all the juices get released. So just constantly stirring that, keeping an eye on this berry sauce. You'll see that the berries have started to burst and it almost looks like a nice liquidy sauce is forming. Now at this stage, we're going to take it off the heat and use an immersion blender and blend the berries just so that we don't have any chunks left in this berry sauce. Now, if you, of course, don't have an immersion blender, you can use a regular blender, you can use a food processor, or you could even try to mash it a bit by using even like a potato press or potato masher, whatever you prefer. At this stage, it doesn't really matter how thick or if there's any chunks left in, because I'm going to be straining this sauce anyway, because I do not want the seeds in the sauce, or at least too many seeds in the sauce. So, for a bowl, we are going to take a strainer and pour the sauce in and press it through. Now a couple seeds is okay, but look how many seeds are left over. That would just be way too many seeds for this delicate sauce. This sauce should lightly thicken in the fridge for basically the same amount of time that the panna cotta will take to be ready, which as we know is about 4 hours in the fridge or even overnight. So what I'm going to be doing now is covering this up with some plastic wrap and placing this in the fridge until I'm ready to use it. Okay, so I am back after the at least 4 hours in the fridge, or in my case, overnight. The panna cotta is ready. You can see the nice natural jiggle to it, which is exactly what we would like. Now it is time to decorate, and like I said, you can do a lot of things with this. You can put a caramel sauce, a chocolate sauce, or even a berry sauce like I did, which is strawberries and raspberries. I wanted to keep some nice red berries just in theme for Valentine's Day, and it's also my favorite berries, so feel free to use yours as well. Now I also have here some fruits, so I have some fresh raspberries and some strawberries that I cut into shapes that almost look heart-like, just to be festive. So let's decorate this one so that I can eat it. I'm just going to scoop on some sauce on the top of this panna cotta. Okay, so I decorated this and now I'm ready to eat this delicious vanilla bean panna cotta with this berry topping. Mmm. Wow. That is so delicate and smooth. Mm. It's the perfect dessert for a beautiful Valentine's Day meal. And guys, it is not too sweet, so it is really delicious. A panna cotta like this could even take on a sweeter caramel sauce because the actual panna cotta itself is not overly sweetened. It is perfect in my opinion. And I just really love the tartness of the strawberries and raspberries with a little bit of that lemon juice in there. It gives it the most perfect combination. It is delicious. And whoever you make this for will surely be very impressed, guys. So I really hope that you give this recipe a try. And if you would like the recipe written and with a few more photos, check out my blog on ladolcelisa.com. I'll have the written recipe and instructions there for you guys as well. And look how festive and pretty this looks. This is sure to wow whoever you make this for. And as you can see, guys, it was actually super easy to make. So please give this a try. I recommend doing this probably the day before Valentine's Day and just having it in the fridge. The good thing is this can keep in the fridge for, I would say, up to 4 or 5 days. So you're good there. A dessert that you can even make ahead of time and is no bake. I mean, you can't go wrong. So again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Ciao, and happy Valentine's Day.